Okay, so I think for the next layout, I'm going to use an image or two out of this Creative Haven Flower Fashion Fantasies coloring book. So these are all girls that are decorated with flowers and leaves and things, and they would make adorable garden fairies. So I'm going to pick a couple of those and color them and fussy cut them and use them on the next layout. So I'm using my X-Acto blade. I've colored this image and I'm using my X-Acto blade to cut out the little pieces that are inside. It's easier to do that when it's solid like this and one page than it is to fussy cut out this whole girl and then try to use your blade to cut out the little pieces inside. You'll have more chances of tearing your image. So always cut your little inside pieces while your page is whole and make sure that your X-Acto blade is really sharp. For fussy cutting, I have these are the Tim Holtz fine fussy cut scissors, and they're not my favorite, to be honest. I like this pair. So I have got these from Amazon and they're not expensive. I'll put a link in. They are so sharp and so fine point that for things like this, you can really get into those little fine points for doing your fussy cutting. So I'll link these and show you what scissors they are, because you might enjoy using these. Okay, so she's colored and cut out. Boy, that was fidgety, but I like how it turned out. Very cute. She's going to be gorgeous on the page. And I've got this magazine image that's got the same kind of flowers, the lilies, and so that's going to make a really nifty background. So maybe she'll be coming out of the big one or something, but somehow I'm going to cut these out, and I'm going to put these down first and then her over them so that they're behind her, because I just think that's really cute. I like the photographic image and then the coloring book image together. And then I am going to make wings for these, and I've got a fun idea for the wings for these garden fairies. How gorgeous this is turning out. The magazine images and the coloring book image on top of each other just looks so great. In fact, I think I might even bump up the colors even more in this to match what's in the magazine photos. So cute, and they're going to have wings. But I just wanted to also give a little shout out and a thank you so much. Send some love out to Catherine and Cynthia. So thank you. I received a tip from each one of you for the videos and the content that I share, and I'm always so grateful for that. So thank you, you guys. Appreciate it. My friend Lori Marie Jenkins used to always say, helps keep the lights on. And this day and age, that's the truth. I think we're all struggling with this high inflation that's currently going on, and I know I certainly am. I sat down to pay my bills, and every single bill that I have has gone up. So this month, compared to last year for the same month, every single bill is higher, which is just crazy. And so, you know that old saying about, I'm not sure how everybody's making ends meet, and kind of thought of that the other day. And then I chuckled to myself, because when I was a kid, you're going to laugh, I heard that saying, make ends meet, and I didn't understand at all what that saying meant. All I could think of was, when you have a pot roast and the ends, we always used to fight over who get the ends of the meatloaf or the ends of the pot roast, and that was the ends of the meat. So meat ends meat. And so when I was a kid and I'd hear the saying of, well, I'm not sure how we're going to make ends meet, I'm like, well, I don't know what you mean, Mom, because you always make pot roast or you always make meatloaf. And then, you know, of course, now as an adult, I totally understand what it means. But as a kid, I didn't understand the make ends meet saying. But so I'm just babbling, but I just wanted to share that funny thing about when I was a kid. And I know that everybody is struggling right now with times being tight and money being hard to come by. So when I do receive a tip, I certainly appreciate it. It helps me out a lot, and I'm super grateful. So thank you so much. This is going to be cute. I'm having fun. And I think that this is going to be just a bright and colorful and cheery page, and I can't wait to do the wings. So that's coming up. So with this image, I've got this cute flower that was out of a magazine, and so I cut across her head here where that leaf is so that I can put this flower and slip it behind the leaves and around her ear like this and put the leaves back down over it. So that's what how I'm going to collage that. And that makes a beautiful headpiece with that flower. Next, I'm going to put down these magazine images over here using matte gel medium. This is Crafter's Workshop matte gel medium, and I'm going to put these flowers in place and let them dry. I need to do the wings before I can put them into place, so the flowers are going to go on first. So for my wings, what I want to do, I haven't glued her down. She's just ready to go in place. I did put tape behind her flower to hold it in place. And I'm going to put her on the page, and I'm getting a piece of vellum. Now, this is a heavy-duty vellum. It's a little bit thicker than regular vellum. And I'm going to slip it under here. So with her in place, I'm going to take a pencil and draw some wings. So I want to kind of design some cute fairy wings. And then the second ones would come out like this. I think I'm just going to do it like that. Okay, so I've drawn my lines in pencil. And then I'm going to cut them out. And then I'll show you my next idea. Here are my wings. I love how they turned out. So just sketching them and then cutting them out. And I think what I'm going to do is to put this through my Sizzix machine with an embosser plate and emboss this vellum. So here are my wings, and then I used this Crafter's Companion floral embossing template and put the vellum wings inside and embossed. So look at these beautiful embossed wings, fairy wings. Looks so pretty. Now what I'm going to do is take a white paint pen and make those lines that separate out the wings. Like that, so you can see that they're individual. That's going to look so pretty. And so now I'm going to do the same thing for this girl. I'm going to put a piece of vellum behind her, draw some wings, and emboss them. So here's how they look on the page. I can't even tell you how much I love the embossed vellum wings. Look at how cute that is. That wasn't what I was planning to do. I did something different, but look at that. So unique and different. Now I just need to put her into place, both of them, on the page and then work on my background. Oh, so cute. Love it. And I added the lettering and words to the page. How dreary the world would be if there were no fairies. I added Nouveau drops to the flowers in white and yellow and this pinky color into the center of the flowers to make them look realistic. And then I used Spectrum Noir glitter ink. I love this stuff. It's one of my favorite go-to things. You shake it up and it's got all this glitter in it. And I just brushed it over those beautiful vellum wings. And so it made their embossed vellum wings glittery. So pretty. And then I added some glitter, just some glue and some glitter drops, so it makes it look like that fairy is dropping her magic. And so that's the page. And oh, I did raise some of these petals. So I put pop dots underneath, so it's got some dimensional petals on the dress. And then there's little Nouveau drop Nouveau drops on there. It just really looks cute. I love how this page turned out so much. So cute. And the really cool part about this is from the previous page where I made those borders. So see how when I fold this page over, the fairy wings make more interesting designs within that border. And you still see through to all the little cutout pieces too. So the pages interact with each other when you lay them over the top of each other. So I hope you enjoyed this and it gives you some inspiration to use a coloring book page, some magazine images, some vellum to draw some fairy wings and emboss them, and to try some of these techniques on some of your art journal pages. So thanks for stopping by. Go play, go make art, because art soothes the heart. And stay tuned for the next video where I show you what I do with the third page in this layout. So stay tuned. There's one more page to complete this layout, this series.